Let's tell an old story anew, and we will see how well you know it. Once upon a time, there were two kingdoms that were the worst of neighbors. In one, lived folk like you and me, under a wrathful king, envious of their peaceful and magical neighbors. Residing beside them were the creatures of the moors. One such spirit among them was a young fairy named Maleficent, adventurous and independent. One day, Maleficent came upon a human named Stefan, a creature she had never seen before. They became the most unlikely of friends and began to dissolve the age-old hatred between humans and fairies. Friendship slowly turned into something more, and on her 16th birthday, Stefan gave Maleficent the gift of true love's kiss, but it was not to be. Stefan was tempted by greed, and his desire to rule over the kingdom was met with a proposal from the dying king. Whoever was able to kill the winged beast Maleficent will inherit the throne and marry the princess. Stefan snuck into the moors to visit Maleficent. Unable to bring himself to kill her, he cut the beautiful wings that Maleficent cherished so much to prove to the king that the beast had been slain. The heart of the once joyful fairy hardened, and she began to rule the moors with an iron grip. The king, true to his word, crowned Stefan the new heir to the throne. One day, Maleficent recruited the likes of a crow named Diavol to be her wings and report her findings between the two kingdoms. As time passed, Maleficent's desire for vengeance grew stronger. When Diavol caught word of a christening at the castle, she knew her chance for revenge had come. They were instructed to keep her safe and bring her back the day after her 16th birthday. Over the child from a distance, but they soon became best friends. Aurora knew her as her fairy godmother.
Cursing the child she had come to love so much. She's headed to the castle. To harm the child that I love so much.
At her side, Maleficent's cold heart was warmed by the light and joy of Aurora brought.